Very good morning, my dear friends. Myself, Dr. M. H. Chennaiah, Vice Principal at Saptagiri College of Engineering, Bangalore. And in today's session, friends, we are going to learn about the projection of a hexagonal lamina. Friends, as the name indicates, a hexagonal lamina is a very thin plate which has got line thickness compared to the lateral dimensions. So it can be considered as a thin plate. And here, he says in the problem, the lamina has got side 30 mm, rests on HP on one of its sides. So we have to first of all analyze the problem. So there is a hexagonal lamina, A, B, C, D, E, F, with each side measuring 30 mm and it is resting on HP on one of its sides. So very obviously, friends, keep the lamina on HP such that one of the side of the lamina is to your left, and obtain the top and front views of the lamina. Friends, here, when you keep the lamina like this, one of the side AB of the lamina is to your left and it is perpendicular to VP. So in the top view, you are going to get the true shape of the lamina, and in the front view, you get a line of this length, which I am going to call it as M later on. So let us start the problem by placing this lamina on HP and obtain the top and front views of the lamina. Friends, here I am going to start the problem by marking the XY line VP and HP. So here this XY line is the line of intersection of VP and HP, the vertical plane and the horizontal plane, and I mark it as VP by HP, indicating the first angle projection which is being followed here. Now when you place the lamina on HP, in the top view, you are going to get a hexagon, a regular hexagon of side 30 mm. So I am going to construct a hexagon here, which has got side, each side measuring 30 mm. And friends, you will just mark this as ABCDF. So this is 30 millimeter side. You can just mark at only one place and name this as ABCD, ABC, D, E and F. Friends, this is the top view of the lamina. Obtain the corresponding lamina. I told you, whenever any lamina is placed on HP, its front view is going to be a line, irrespective of the orientation of the lamina with VP. So I am going to get a line here, this line, and this I am going to mark it as the front view, and let us name it as A dash, B dash. This is C and F will come together. So this is C dash, F dash, and this is D dash, E dash. And this length I represent as M. So this measurement of M can be obtained after the construction of the figure. Friends, you can observe here, the lamina is resting on HP, and the surface of the lamina represented by this horizontal line on XY is horizontal. He says in the question, the lamina is resting on the side AB, but the side opposite to that is 20 mm above HP. So friends, remember, in this problem, either the height of this side, opposite side from the HP can be given, or the angle made by the surface of the lamina may also be given. So here, what I do, the lamina is resting on HP, and I am going to redraw this lamina such that the side opposite to AB on which it is resting is 20 mm above HP. Friends, I am going to mark the locus of the opposite side at a height of 20 mm above HP or above the XY line. So select some point at random on the XY line, mark it as A dash, B dash. Now friends, taking A dash, B dash as center and this length M as radius, I am going to strike an arc here. Friends, this is going to be the side D dash, E dash. And exactly in the center, you have C dash, F dash. So I am going to mark it as C dash, F dash. Friends, whatever the front view we had in the first position is redrawn such that the side DE opposite to the side on which it is resting is 20 mm above HP. And friend, they can also ask you in this problem, to find out what is the inclination of the surface of the lamina. So if you measure this angle will give you theta, the inclination of the surface of the lamina with the HP. Friends, as per the regular procedure, obtain all the six corners of the lamina and hence the top view of the lamina. So I am going to start with this line A. A vertical line from A, a horizontal line from here will give you the corner A. Similarly, vertical line from B, horizontal line from B will give you this point B. Similarly, obtain point C, F, D, etc. by following the same procedure. So friends, here you are going to get here the other points. I'll just mark them. So here this point is going to be F, and this is going to be C here. This is D, this point is E, and this point is F. So friends, we have got exactly all the six points. Join all these points so obtained by straight lines. So you can start with A. A to B, B to C is the second side, C to D, D to E, E to F. And whatever the figure I have shown here is the top view of the lamina. When the side opposite to the side on which it is resting, that is DE, is 20 mm above HP. And friends, now you can just observe in the top view, the lamina, the side AB of the lamina is now perpendicular to VP. That is to say, it is resting on side AB, that side AB is now perpendicular to VP. But in the question he says, draw the projections of the lamina when the side on which it rests is parallel to VP and nearer to it. So friends, here the side AB is normal to VP. So I have to redraw this top view such that this is to be redrawn at an angle of 90. After rotating to 90 degrees, we have to draw this figure. So if I call this as figure number 2, I am going to redraw this figure such that the side AB becomes horizontal or the side AB becomes parallel to VP. Friends, how to construct this is another part of this question. Friends, whatever the figure you have got here, excepting for the rectangle and the squares, the figure has to be enclosed in a box. So friends, I am going to enclose this hexagon in a box, and I call that box or name that box as PQRS. P, this is Q, this is R, and this is S. So I have drawn or enclosed the hexagon in a box, PQRS. Now I am going to redraw this figure, this box PQRS, such that this PQ becomes horizontal, because AB, the side on which it is resting, has to become parallel to VP. So I am going to redraw that figure here, PQRS. So a rectangle here. This is the box PQRS in which you have enclosed this hexagon. So this AB has to be nearer to VP. So I should write PQ here. So this will be PQ, this is R, and this is finally S. So in this box PQRS, we have to obtain this figure ABCDEF. How to obtain? It is very simple. From P, just find out what the distance of A. So mark the distance on PQ from P. So this is going to be the point A. Similarly, at the same distance from Q, we have got B. This is going to be point B. So we have got A and B. Next comes, you can just hear, exactly in between P and S, you have got F. Between P and S, you have got the point F. Next, between R and Q, or QR, you have got C. You have got this C. So if you draw a horizontal line, it will just go and touch this. So similarly, on the other side, on SR, SR is here, E is closer to S. If you just project a line from here, you will get this point as E, and finally the other point is D. So A, B, C, this is going to be the point D. Friends, you can see here, You got all the 6 points of the lamina, and I am going to join all these by straight lines. So AB, AF, AE, BC, and EF finally. Friends, here we have redrawn this figure number 2 with AB being parallel to VP and nearer. I'll just mark here AB parallel to VP and nearer to it. So friends, so we have got the final top view. I can say this is the top view of the lamina, wherein you have to give importance only for this figure ABCDEF, and the rectangle has to be shown by thin line. So friends, let us obtain the final front view of this. So let us start with the point A. AB is here. So vertical line from here, horizontal line from here drawn. They intersect at this point. We call this as point A dash. Similarly, horizontal line from B, vertical line from B, they meet here. We call this point as B dash. So on the same lines, you obtain point C and F. It comes exactly in the center here, C and F. So C and F you want. F is here. This is the point when you get this F from there. And on the other side, you have got C. So friends, you have got, this is point C dash, this is point F dash. Finally, you should get D and E. So draw a horizontal line from D dash, vertical line from D. The point where they meet is that point D dash. Finally, we have got A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. E we should obtain. Vertical line from here, a horizontal line from here. The point of intersection will give you the point E dash. Friends, you got all the 6 points or 6 corners of the lamina in the front view. Join these points by straight line. So I am going to join A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to F, and F to A. That is F dash to A dash. Friends, the figure A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, F dash obtained is the final front view of the lamina. So friends, we have got the complete solution wherein the lamina looks as an hexagon distorted in both the top view and front view. And one thing you should remember, friends, here the side AB on which it is resting is measuring 30 here, the same 30 you find here, 30, 30. So all these sides, A dash, B dash, AB, ED, and E dash, D dash, will measure again 30 millimeter. And friends, I hope all of you have followed the explanation made on this particular problem on hexagonal lamina. If you are really happy with the presentation I have made, do subscribe to my channel, Mechanical Engineering Lecture Series. Share the information with all your friends, and this will help me to make more and more such good videos in many of the engineering subjects. So thank you, my dear friends, for watching my YouTube TV channel, and have a wonderful day. This is Dr. M.H. Annaya signing off.